neighborhood with 55 different languages were spoken. If people are speaking 55 different languages, in order for you to get along, you're going to have to learn to speak English, right? The Iraqis that you're talking about, they came because of, you know, they came because of war. They didn't want to come. They spent all those years in a refugee camp before they came. They came to Dearborn, the Dearborn we live in today, where you can go to the bank, you can go to the grocery store, you can go to the doctor. There's not a service you want that you can't get in Arabic right now. So those are the two big reasons. And even you know that those immigrants told other immigrants, don't come to Dearborn, go to Ohio first, learn English, and then come to Detroit. Because if you come to Detroit, you'll never learn English. But if you look at the children of these Iraqis, and I know because they're the students I'm teaching. The students or those Iraqis are just as American as any other student in our university.
They don't speak Arabic.
Well, most of them do, because their parents really don't speak English. But you know, the children of these Iraqis, they really do still speak Arabic, but they're American, and their future is here, and you know, that's the real difference. That's the real difference.
I can add to it, it's not only Iraqis, also Lebanese. I know a lot of Lebanese that they don't speak a word of English. Just for, so simple. They don't need it. You are in a city where everything is provided in Arabic, so why? That's it. Okay, I just want to thank Dr. Howell. Thank you very much. We'll see you when you publish the new book.